Today I'm going to be sharing a quick bi-directional test that you can use on the air suspension in your car using a scan tool. I'm in a 2010 Lexus RX450h hybrid and I'll be using the XTOOL IP819TP. This is a test that you can use to help detect leaks or issues with your air suspension. Now let's get this. I'll click on Diagnosis, select Lexus. This car is the European spec. Automatic detection, it's the 2010 before September. Okay, system selection, and then air suspension. This ECU controls suspension and absorber actuators based on wheel speed, steering wheel rotation, and G-force. Okay, I'll select actuation tests. Here you can see there are a number of components in the air suspension to test. The solenoids, which if they are bad, would definitely give you sagging on the affected sides. There's the relay as well, which may lead to the air compressor not coming on at all if it's bad. But for today, I'm just going to actuate the height of one of the wheels. Let me select the air suspension on the right front wheel. This test will adjust the height of the front right wheel. Vehicle height status can be found on live data. Execute condition, engine should be idling, foot is off the brake, and all doors are closed. I'll turn on the car. So it's on EV mode at the moment, and that should give you a better opportunity of hearing any of the inflation sounds or the air compressor. Okay, let's monitor some live data PIDs. I'll select the height control sensors for all the wheels, just so we see the height of the other wheels in relation to the front right that we're going to be testing. Then I'll also select the left and right front height adjustments. Okay, air suspension test mode displays on the dash, showing that we're ready to start testing. Just to say that the car is not parked on a flat surface, this should have been on a level surface, that just isn't available where I'm at. So you'd notice that the wheels are at different heights, as you can see. So just keep your eyes focused on the right front wheel. We can see that at the moment is at 14.9 millimeters. I'll press up. And it goes up to 18.3 millimeters. If you're suspecting a leak at this wheel, you might want to hold this position while you inspect the air suspension. If there's a leak, you also notice that this height will begin to reduce on live data. If it doesn't inflate at all, that could be the air compressor itself or the relay. And then I'll push down. And it takes it down from the 18.3 to about the 10 millimeter mark. Not sure if you're able to visualize that on camera, but you may have heard the sound of air escaping from the suspension. I'll turn the test procedure off, and then the car goes out of test mode. Hope this has been helpful. Catch you on the next one. Peace.